Okay, we're going to go over this problem about how to find the equation of a tangent line when I need to do implicit differentiation. And to find tangent lines, we're going to do the same thing we always have. One, we're going to find the derivative. In this case, that will look like finding y prime. Two, I'm going to plug my x value into the derivative to get the slope of the tangent line. Third, if I don't have the y value, I need to get that, right? Plug x into the original equation, that's what I meant to say, to get the y value for the point. So now I have the slope and an x and y value. This is a point. So write the equation. Using like x minus x1, I'm writing this in the reverse order. Y minus y1 is equal to m times x minus x1. And then you're done. Okay? Okay, so I want to, this is my problem, y squared minus xy, and I think it's plus 10 is equal to 0. Good. And I need to the first step is to find the derivative of this. Okay, so implicitly I'm going to take the derivative of this piece by piece. So the derivative of y squared is 2y times y prime, right? Then this xy piece is the product rule, x times y, and we have done this before, so I'm going to set u is equal to x, u prime is 1. V is equal to y, v prime is just y prime, and so I get uv prime plus v prime plus v u prime. So I get x times y prime plus y times 1. So I get xy prime plus y is how we probably would write that. So, and I'm going to put that in parentheses because there's this minus sign. If I don't put it in the parentheses, I'm going to miss this sign. And the derivative of 10 is 0, and the derivative of 0 is 0, right? So I have 2y, y prime, minus xy prime, plus y is equal to 0. And then here are my y primes, right there and right there, that I need to solve for. So I'm going to move this y to the other side, subtract y. I'm left with 2y, y prime, minus xy prime is equal to negative y. Again, I'm going to keep track. There's my y prime. There's my y prime. I'm going to factor that guy out. Then there's 2y minus x is equal to negative y. And then divide everywhere by 2y minus x. So y prime is equal to negative y over 2y minus x. Perfect. Okay, so that is the derivative. Y prime is the derivative. So 2, I'm going to plug, and the point I need to plug in is x equal to negative 7 into y prime. So I'm going to find y prime at x equal to negative 7. And that is, oh, look here. So I know what x is, but I don't know what y is. And here, if you're keeping track, I need to know what the y is at negative 7 in order to plug in. No problem. Okay, I'm going to start this other side because step 3 is to find y by plugging into the original equation. And really, I could have done this in step 1, no problem. I just usually do it in step 3 in the tangent line because that's when I remember to do it. So I'm going to plug this into the original equation, which was y squared minus xy plus 10 is equal to 0. Hold on, I'm going to go make sure that that's, yep. Okay, and so I don't know what y is, so I'm going to leave those there. And I'm going to plug in negative 7 for x. So I get y squared plus 7y plus 10 is equal to 0. Okay. And then I'm going to solve this for y. So I'm going to factor this. Y plus 5 times y plus 2 is equal to 0. So I get y is equal to negative 5 and y is equal to negative 2. Now, if this happens, it means there are two points on your equation that are associated with negative 7. It's probably why this is defined implicitly. Okay, so that means that I'm going to get two tangent lines. One, I have one at the point negative 7, negative 5 here, and another one at the point negative 7, negative 2. Okay, so let's come back over here. Okay, so I have these two points. I'm going to find two tangent lines. Okay, so I'm going to let's do the point negative 7, negative 5 first. Okay, so now I'm going to plug this into y prime, and I'm going to remember that y prime is negative y over 2y minus x, right? So I'm going to plug in this value. So I get the y value is negative 5. Negative and negative 5, right? Because there's a negative. 2 times negative 5 minus negative 7. There's a lot of negatives floating around here. 5. This is 2 times negative 5 is negative 10 plus 7, which is 5 over negative 3, or negative 5/3. Okay? And then I'm going to go ahead, I think I'm going to go ahead and write this line here because I have everything I need. So y minus negative 5 is equal to negative 5/3 times x minus, and then negative 7. I might write it like that. And these really turn into pluses. I just sometimes write stuff to make sure that you're being careful about signs because it can trip you up. So I get y is equal to negative 5/3 x minus 35/3 minus 5. So we don't like fractions, I know, but I'll get negative 35/3, and if I put the 5 over 3, it's negative 15/3. So I get y is equal to negative 5/3 x minus, and this should be 50/3, I think. Okay? Okay, so now I'm going to do the same thing for this value at negative 7, negative 2, because there's a second tangent line. So here I go. Negative 7, negative 2, and y prime is, hold on, I need to remember what this is. What is it? Negative y over 2y minus x. Negative y minus x. Okay. So now y prime at negative 7, negative 2 is, I'm going to put, so negative negative 2, 2 times negative 2 minus negative 7. This is positive 2 up here, negative 4 plus 7, 2 over 3, 2/3. Beautiful. Okay. And then I have this point, so I'm going to do y, and I'm not going to do the negative negatives, but this is y plus 2 is equal to 2/3 times x plus 7. Y is equal to 2/3 x plus 14/3. And then minus the 2 from the other side. 14/3 minus, and this is 6/3. So I get y is equal to 2/3 x. 14 minus 6 is 8/3. Oh, but I do need a plus in here. Maybe I'll spread this out a little bit. Plus 8/3. Okay, so even if the derivative is much grosser to find, after you find the derivative, like find this x value, find the y value, plug them in, and find these tangent lines. Okay, let me know if you have any questions.